Hey Canucks fans, it's the Canucks and it's the Penguins. Are we in store for another 14-goal game? I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter, and I'm at Clay Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take, all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Saturday, December the 21st. And you may have seen on Twitter, it's my lovely daughter Kayla. It's her 12th birthday today. Happy birthday, Kayla. We love you very much. And thus, I won't be going to the game tonight because all our school friends are coming over for a little party tonight. So aside from helping them out, serving food, you know, making sure everything's okay, making sure they're not beating each other up. No, they're not going to beat each other up. They're friends. Well, I hope not. I'll be also watching the game tonight on TV, up and downstairs kind of thing, checking it out. So, of course, I will not be going to the game in person tonight. But I'm looking forward to a good game. I'll get to that in a second. As well, you may have seen I didn't do a Canucks vlog yesterday because I was too busy sharing my commercial. Yes, I got actually hired to do an ad for working with a marketing company in spreading the word about comparison.ca. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you can check out, if you want to, my video from yesterday where I did a quick 2-minute commercial on this brand new website that might be helpful to you over the holiday season. But enough about that. You can check out that video if you want to, comparison.ca. Okay, let's talk about the Canucks. Let's talk about the Penguins. I mentioned that 14-goal outburst because last time these two teams played, it was in Pittsburgh, it was in November, and that's the game. The Canucks were up 6-3 in the third, and they ended up losing 8-6 because they allowed 5 straight goals in the third period. And yes, 8 plus 6 makes 14 goals. And Pittsburgh is good. You could argue that that game actually started the Canucks slide in November, so maybe it's a chance to right the ship, so to speak, tonight. And the Canucks can build on that wonderful 5-4 victory, that spirited, chippy victory over the Vegas Golden Knights on Thursday night. So I'll talk about the ramifications, the follow-up from that game in a second. But in the Penguins, this is a really good team. They have 45 points in, I think actually it's 46 points in 35 games. 46 points, but that only puts them fourth in the very competitive Metropolitan Division. You have you have Washington there, you have the Islanders there, you have Carolina there all bunched up, and then you have Pittsburgh all within a few points of each other. Let's put this in perspective. If Pittsburgh had those 46 points and was in the Pacific Division, they'd be number one. They'd be ahead of Arizona and Vegas and Calgary and Edmonton. So that's how good that Metropolitan Division is, and that's how good the Penguins have been playing. Again, 46 points in only 35 games compared to the 38 points the Canucks have in 36 games. So they don't have Crosby, we know that, but they still have Jake Guentzel, they still have Evgeny Malkin, they still have Jared McCann, they still have Chris Letang, they still have Matt Murray. So they are a very, very good team. So the Canucks will obviously have to play even better than they did against Vegas. Hopefully they won't get as injured as they did against Vegas, because we learned today that Josh Levo will be out of the Canucks lineup for 2 to 3 months with a fractured kneecap. And we saw that the way he was pushed into the boards by Holden and his right knee smashed against the dasher, the bottom of the boards, and it did not look good at the time. So 2 to 3 months, it could have been a lot worse. It could have been the whole season, 4 to 6 months, but 2 to 3 months is still bad and a big blow for the Vancouver Canucks. And I'll talk about who's going to come in this place in a second. Other injury notes, Alex Edler and Thatcher Demko were on the ice this morning ahead of the practice or with the practice, but Edler will not play tonight. Maybe he'll play on Monday against Edmonton, and Demko will not back up yet. It'll still be Michael DiPietro. And then Brandon Sutter was not on the ice. Michael Ferlin, hopefully soon, but they haven't said much about him as well. So those are the guys that are still out. You got Demko, you got Ferlin, you got Levo now, you got Edler, and you got Sutter. And Edler is probably, out of all those guys, will probably be the guy to be the first one back. So no Josh Levo. Your options were Sutter, still injured, Louis Erickson, who was sitting on the bench for the last few games, and Zach McEwen, who they just called up. And you may have seen, it is indeed Louis Erickson. The same Louis Erickson that has 1 point in 17 games this season. He will be on the second line, running shotgun with Bo Horvat and Tanner Pearson. So the lines and D pairings look like this for the Canucks. You have the Lotto line, Pettersson, Besser, and Miller. Then you have Horvat between Erickson and Pearson. Your third line, our favorite third line, is Gaudette with Roussel and Virtanen. And then the fourth line, the very effective line, very effective fourth line, Beagle, Schaller, and Mott. And then on D, same pairing as last time. You have Hughes playing with Tanev, Fantenberg playing with Myers, Ben playing with Stetcher, and Jacob Markstrom in net. So the only change from the lineup that played against and defeated the Golden Knights on Thursday night is Louis Erickson in for the injured Josh Levo. Let's talk about Louis Erickson. like I said, if Sutter was an option, maybe he comes in. But it was either going to be Erickson or whoever they just called up, Zach McEwen, who probably just arrived today, considering they just announced it this morning. Actually, I think they announced it yesterday. So he had time, but he was out of practice, but playing on a extra pairing with Jalen Chatfield, the extra D-man right now, because Fantenberg's playing because Edler's out. So, it wasn't McEwen, it was Erickson. And it makes sense from a standpoint of he's played with Bo before. He's obviously played in the NHL a lot. He hasn't played a lot this season. But it's probably the least disruption. You could put McEwen in, actually, but if you put McEwen in, I don't think you put him in as a second line winger. So then you have to move someone up, like a Virtanen or a Roussel or a Mott, whoever it is, and then put McEwen properly in a third or fourth line. So then you're disrupting two lines, so to speak. So in putting Erickson in for Josh Leivo, you're only disrupting one line, and the other three lines stay intact. And those three lines were very effective, as we saw against Vegas. So if you believe in chemistry and you believe in not rocking the boat too much, this move probably made the most sense, despite how much people probably don't want to see Louis Erickson in the lineup. So again, you have your Lotto line, you have your third line, you have your fourth line still intact from Thursday. The only change is Erickson in for Josh Leivo. So it's really unfortunate news for Josh Leivo, but like I said, it could have been worse. Of course, it could have been better, but 2 to 3 months, the Canucks are going to have to figure out what to do without him, whether that is Louis Erickson's a long-term solution, whether McEwen gets in time, they swap guys around, or is this another chance for a guy like Sven Berchi, Nikolai Godobin, someone who can play in the top six? You can argue and quibble about how effective they are, but at least they can play in the top six and not look out of place and not disrupt the lineup that much. So that's something to keep an eye on right now. So there we go. Tonight's the Vancouver. It's Pittsburgh. It's the powerhouse Penguins. They come in winning 4 straight, winning 7 of their last 8. So this is going to be a very, very tough test. I'll be watching, like I said, in between taking care of Kayla and her friends. And I will check in, hopefully, with some intermission reflections as I do when I can. And, of course, a post-game vlog at the end. So enjoy the game. Tell me what you think in the comments below. I'd love for you to leave a comment on this whole, are you okay with it being Louis Erickson for Josh Leivo? What do you think of Josh Leivo's injury? Are you mad? Are you surprised that Holden didn't get any supplementary discipline for that horrible hit? And who do you think is going to win tonight? And by what score? Who is going to be a big star for the Canucks? Who do they need to step up? A lot of questions, but we just remember how crazy the game was the last time these two teams met back in November. So leave a comment below. I love to read, react, and reply as always. If you want to greet Kayla a happy birthday, I'll pass that on to her as I've done on Twitter throughout the day. So thank you. If you want to leave more comments, as some of you were able to check out my ad from yesterday and leave some fun comments below that. So if you want to check that out as well, I certainly wouldn't complain. But more importantly, Vancouver, Pittsburgh tonight, Rogers Arena. And I can't wait. It's the penultimate game. There's my favorite word. The penultimate game before their Christmas break. Let me know who you think is going to win. Leave a comment below. Have a great day. Oh, I forgot. Subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Now, enjoy the day. Enjoy the game. God bless. Go Canucks, go.